It's associated more with country houses, coastlines and cream teas, but now the National Trust is celebrating what some might say is the worst of what Britain has to offer.
Yeah, referred to as brutalist architecture. They're the concrete jungles that were built during the 1960s. Should they be cherished and preserved for future generations, sir?
Well, let's have a look at some examples of brutalist architecture and you'll soon be able to take a tour around these ones.
Joe Watson from the National Trust and architect Harriet Harris. The music there was by Vangelis, the theme from Blade Runner, A Vision of a Dystopian Future. Have we just had it, looking at that architecture?
Definitely not. Definitely not. Utopian architecture, I think it's fantastic.
Really utopian?
Yes, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
What do you think of it, Harriet? I mean, you look at the these buildings, they're not sort of cosy buildings in any way, but they're, maybe they're not meant to be like that.
Well, personally, I think that brutalist buildings are actually quite sexy. Not many buildings offer you the opportunity to go and stroke them. And you kind of have this slightly Jurassic experience because normally with the concrete, it's poured using timber, and the timber has a relief onto the building, which is why you get that lovely texture. So you could actually take the kids out for the weekend and get them to stroke buildings and experience this sort of Jurassic document.
It's never occurred to me to do that until you've said it.
People who lived in brutalist tower blocks didn't want to stroke them after a while when they were full of damp. They just wanted to knock them down with a sledgehammer.
And that's quite understandable, actually, because one of the problems with many of the social housing projects after the war is that it was a wonderful heroic manifesto from local authorities to address a housing crisis, but they did it in a very rushed way. And often the materials used, and certainly some of the builders involved, they were experimenting with a very new sculptural technology, which was concrete, and they didn't always know what they were doing with the structures and so on, which is why you had classic failures like Ronan Point 1968, which collapsed and killed three people. But unfortunately, if we invest in the buildings and recover them, we can actually do a lot to maintain them.
So what you're going to do in the National Trust now is you're going to offer people special tours. I mean, you really think that that's what should be done with this architecture?
We really do, yes, absolutely. I mean, this is just a logical extension of what the National Trust already does. So, you know, we obviously care for places for the benefit of the nation. We open them to people so that they can see what they're like, you know, and understand something of a particular era of history. Mm. History didn't stop in 1950, you know, so here we are moving our way into the 1960s and trying to understand that era and trying to help people to understand this architecture in a better way.
So are we looking or are we celebrating?
Well, we're exploring, I think. Exploring is probably what I would say. I mean, there's a little bit of celebration, I think. There's definitely something about wanting to say that this was, Harriet just used the word, heroic. It was a heroic era. And, you know, one of the important things, I think, to say about architecture, full stop, is it's a very good indicator of where the power lies in our society. When you look at the church, you look at the aristocracy, and here we are, there's this sort of amazing moment in the 1950s and 1960s where the power is really with the people. It's with the local councils, it's with the people, it's, you know, we're creating this big, heroic, rather sublime architecture.
Harriet, you're obviously a big fan. Have you got a particular building that you like that's brutalist architecture?
Well, there's so many, in fact, but I suppose the National Theatre by Dennis Lasdon is particularly interesting because it captures one of the ambitions of brutalism, which was to make, if you like, the arts and culture accessible to a diverse section of society, not to be something exclusive only for the rich. And it actually translates, if you like, the stages, the activity of the interior onto the facade of the building. So if you actually look at the images, you can see these extended decks, which operate in many ways as a stage. So it's externalising all of the activity.
Brutalist sounds like a criticism of the form of architecture, but in fact it comes from the French, doesn't it?
That's right. It comes from the French, beton brut, meaning simply raw concrete.
Is that something that people are still using these days, or have we completely changed now, do you think, Harry?
No, it's very much a technology that we understand so much more about. I think one of the challenges is that as a material it needs to be highly maintained. Certainly in the 1960s we weren't necessarily, when we were using concrete to reinforce, steel to reinforce the concrete, we weren't understanding that actually concrete is porous, much like a sponge.
Right, so how, you talk about highly maintained, what do you need to do then?
Well, normally you'd have to make sure that you were using certain treatments on the facade, and certainly with the steel reinforcements they also need to be in some way insulated against the water passage that the concrete presents to the steel.
Joe, this is University of East Anglia. You've said this sort of architecture is sublime. Other people just found it, well, quote Prince of Wales' term, it looks like a monstrous carbuncle.
I know. Yes, he certainly did use that term. But, I mean, really, this architecture was designed in a way to become part of the landscape. And I think one of the sort
of... Do you
think
it was part of the landscape?
Absolutely, yes, definitely, at the University of East Anglia. That's exactly what Laslin intended, that these would be sort of like hillocks in the landscape. And part of the size of the architecture as well is absolutely redolent of that idea of sublimity and being sort of large and overpowering.
Well, still inspiring debate after all.
Absolutely. I'm sure you've inspired people to go and look at it as well.
And stroke.
Yeah, I wasn't going to mention that, but I'm glad you have.
We want to know if you have brutalist buildings in your area and if you want them to stay or go. If you like stroking, and perhaps you can send photos in through email or our Facebook page. And thank you very much.
It's changed my view forever, that. Thank you.